Welcome to Understand the Math. In the video description, you'll find a link to guided notes that can be downloaded and filled in as you follow along with the video. In this video, I'm going to define what the six trigonometric functions are for a right triangle, define what reciprocal relationships are for these functions, and then work through some example problems where we need to find the trigonometric functions of a right triangle when all three side lengths or one of the trigonometric functions are given. There are six trigonometric functions that relate the angles of a right triangle to the ratios of the sides of the right triangle. We'll begin by assigning theta to be an acute angle in our right triangle. Let's go ahead and let's assign one of the acute angles to be theta. Let's now label the sides. The side closest to theta is called the adjacent side. The side opposite theta is called the opposite side. And then we can label the last one as the hypotenuse. I'm now going to define our six trigonometric functions. Our first function is sine theta, and that is equal to the length of the opposite side divided by the length of the hypotenuse. Our next function is cosine theta, and that is equal to the length of the adjacent side divided by the length of the hypotenuse. Our third function is our tangent function, and that is the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side. Our cosecant function is the ratio of the hypotenuse divided by the opposite side. Our secant function is the hypotenuse divided by the adjacent side. Our last function is our cotangent function, and that is the ratio of the length of the adjacent side to the opposite side. The three main trigonometric functions that we'll work with are sine, cosine, and tangent. In the black box above, let's notice the difference between sine theta and cosecant theta. They both have ratios that involve the opposite side and the hypotenuse, but their ratios are flipped. The relationship between sine theta and cosecant theta is called a reciprocal relationship. This means that cosecant theta is 1 divided by sine theta, just like sine theta is 1 divided by cosecant theta. Secant theta is defined as 1 over cosine theta, and then cosine theta is defined as 1 over secant theta. And then lastly, cotangent theta is 1 over tangent theta, and tangent theta is 1 over cotangent theta. The nice thing about the reciprocal relationships is if you have one of the functions, you can find the other one. We typically find sine, cosine, and tangent first, and then use those functions to find cosecant, secant, and cotangent. We're now going to do some example problems where we'll use right triangles to evaluate trigonometric functions. Let's just make a list on the left-hand side of those six trigonometric functions. So we're going to have sine theta, cosine theta, tangent theta, and then their reciprocal functions. Cosecant theta, secant theta, and cotangent theta. The first problem, we are given a triangle where we're given angle theta, we're given the opposite side, and we're given the hypotenuse, and we're asked to find all six trigonometric functions. The first step we need to do is to use the Pythagorean theorem to find the length of the adjacent side, because that's the side length that we're not given. To begin, let's label our sides. I'm going to label the right side as A, the bottom side as B, and we'll call the hypotenuse C. The Pythagorean theorem states, based on this, that the square of one side, which we'll call A squared, plus the square of the other side, which we'll call b squared, is equal to the square of the hypotenuse c squared. We can now plug in the values. So a is 8, so we have 8 squared plus b squared. We can't plug anything in for that because that's the value that we're going to find. But we can plug in for c. So c is 17 squared. So 8 squared is 64 plus b squared is equal, and you can throw this one in your calculator unless you know it. 17 squared is 289. We then isolate b squared on the left, so we'll subtract 64 from both sides of the equation. So we have 289 minus 64. And that gives us 225, which is a nice number, because the square root of 225 is 15. Let's go ahead and add B to our diagram. So B is equal to 15. The next step is to find the three main trigonometric functions, sine theta, cosine theta, and tangent theta. We learned on the previous page that sine theta is defined to be the length of the opposite side, so we'll abbreviate that OPP, divided by the hypotenuse, which we'll abbreviate HYP. The length of the opposite side is 8, and the length of the hypotenuse is 17. So the value of sine theta is 8 over 17. Our cosine theta is defined to be the adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse. Our adjacent side, that's the value we just found, so that's 15, and our hypotenuse is 17 still. And then our tangent function, tangent theta, is our opposite divided by our adjacent. Our opposite side is equal to 8, and our adjacent side is 15. Our last step is to find the three remaining trigonometric functions. So we can use reciprocal relationships to do this, and it'll be a little bit easier. So cosecant theta is 1 over sine theta. So we invert sine theta and we get 17 over 8. Secant theta is 1 over cosine theta. So we'll invert cosine theta and we get 17 over 15. And then lastly, we have cotangent theta is 1 over tangent theta. So we'll invert tangent theta and we'll arrive at a value of 15 divided by 8. In our second example, we're given the value of one trigonometric function, and we're asked to find the value of the other 5 trigonometric functions. We'll begin by letting theta be the angle in the lower left, and then we'll make a note that cosine theta is equal to the adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse. And that's, we're given that is 5 over 13. So we can now label two sides and then use the Pythagorean theorem to find the missing side. So our adjacent side is 5 and our hypotenuse is 13. So let's call the adjacent side B, our unknown side we'll call A, and our hypotenuse we'll call C. So the Pythagorean theorem says one side squared plus the other side squared is equal to the hypotenuse squared. So the side that we don't know is A, so that we'll leave that as A squared. B squared is going to be 5 squared, and then C squared is 13 squared. So this gives us A squared plus 25 is 169. We'll subtract 25 from both sides of the equation. So we have 169 minus 25. That's equal to 144. And then lastly, we'll take the square root of both sides and we'll get A is equal to 12. So we have our missing side. Let's go ahead and let's add that to our picture. The next thing we need to do is find the other two main trigonometric functions, sine theta and tangent theta. Sine theta, our graph's going to move out of the way. Let's see if we can keep some of it. So sine theta is our opposite side divided by our hypotenuse. So that's 12 over 13. And then our tangent function is our opposite side divided by our adjacent side. So that's going to be 12 divided by 5. We're almost done. The last thing that we need to do is to find the remaining 3 trigonometric functions. We'll again use this reciprocal relationships. So we know that secant theta is 1 over cosine theta. We're going to have to scroll back up to find cosine theta. That's 5 over 13. So the reciprocal of that is going to be 13 over 5. Cosecant theta is 1 over sine theta. And we just found that in step 3. We'll take the reciprocal of it and we'll get 13 over 12. And then lastly, we have our cotangent theta, which is 1 over tangent theta, which is going to be 5 over 12. You should now be able to calculate trigonometric functions.